Hey guys, what's going on? DZ here with Newbie Drone. Today is the 17th, yesterday was the 16th, and the GoPro 9 came out. So what we are doing is we're gonna fly in the field, we're gonna compare the GoPro 9 to the GoPro 8, also to the Insta360 R, maybe the Osmo, to see which one is the king.
There you are.
Jesus, after 20 minutes.
Found it!
Still intact.
Pretty good.
Still recording.
So after flying all the different quads with all the different action cams, I'm ready to give you guys some feedback. So we're gonna start with the Osmo action. I really like that you can screw off and screw on different lenses. So if you do end up breaking it, you can fix that. So that's an X for the GoPro 8. Another thing I wanna say about Osmo is they're actually pretty quick on updating the firmware. They fixed all the glitches that I've heard about. For instance, the front facing screen used to be really laggy and they took care of that. So, another thing is it has a front facing color screen. So you can use it for vlogging and stuff. That's another thumbs up for Osmo. Some downfalls on the Osmo, the auto white balance is kind of weird. You can't use real steady. It does have rock steady and it actually works really well, but there are some limitations going with the Osmo. Next, let's talk about the GoPro 8. I hate the fact that the front lens is not removable as a drone person, because that means as soon as we crash, we gotta replace it. So that's the first thing I do not like about it. It also takes very high quality video that works either with just the GoPro stabilization or real steady, so you have the option on that, so that's really cool. So the GoPro 9, kudos for you guys for only messing up on the 8 and making the lens removable on the 9 again, because we appreciate that. You probably appreciate that too, because you get less warranty swaps at Best Buy. The GoPro 9 also does 5K. They just released real steady compatibility with the 9. It also does 4K at 60 and all that jazz. So very high quality camera. Some of the drawbacks, it is a little bit bigger and a little bit, 30 grams heavier than the 8. And for guys like us that put things in the air, that's quite a bit of weight. Lastly, we have the Insta360 R. Some things that I do like about it is it's modular. So if you do happen to break one piece, you just have to replace that one piece. The lens is removable and it's a hefty, nice lens. We also crashed the heck out of that. Also, Insta360 is really good about updating their firmware when it comes to both on the camera and also on the editing software that you use. They're really good at updating that kind of stuff. They actually listen to the FPV community when it comes to feedback. You saw it with InstaGo. So on the software side, I think they're trying to catch up. They still got some catching up to do to get to the GoPro level, but I'd say if there is another horse in the race, it would be the Insta360 R. I would say the sharpness actually beats out the 9. It's a 1-inch sensor, so we're gonna actually do some low light comparisons between the 9 and the R also, and I'm willing to bet the R is gonna come out on top on those as well. So I think those are our top two right now, is the GoPro 9 and the Insta360 R. I'm not sure who's gonna be king. I almost have my money on the Insta360 R. For those of you that aren't sure what action cam to get and you don't have one, I guess it really depends on your price, what you're gonna be doing with it. But here at Newbie Drone, what we do have is we have the Osmo, which is really good for vlogging, also a kind of lower priced but you can still do things like 240 HD at 1080p. You can change the lenses, so the Osmo is a really good option for those that don't need like the craziest software and the craziest stabilization and the craziest resolution, but really want something that's really versatile. Osmo is really good for that. We also sell the Insta360 R in both the 1-inch mod and also the regular mod that comes with a 360 and then a 4K mod along with it. So depending on, again, what your use case is, if you're trying to do some very high quality shooting in low light, or you need extra sharpness or something, I would go with the Insta360 R with the 1-inch. If you're trying to do that cool 360 stuff, you can get the Insta360 R with the 360 mod, and that also comes with the 4K cam. So basically, you get a GoPro, right, at the 4K mod, and then also 360 cam. So those are my two suggestions. If you're trying to go for the highest, I would just go with the Insta360 R with the 1-inch lens. You're gonna get the best quality out of that, and then we'll see what happens with the software. But if you need a GoPro, I can't help you. I'm sorry, you gotta go to Best Buy and then like buy the insurance, and then every time you crash it, give it to them, then they end up losing money, then they remember you. Like Rotor Bob, he just walks into GoPro and they know who he is, they just give him a new GoPro. Don't be that guy.